Every year on May 5th, Indigenous women and girls are remembered across the country, usually by hanging red dresses in public spaces to represent the lives of women lost to violence. That red dress symbol has made its way onto a hand-beaded pin sold at a warehouse books in Regina's Cathedral neighborhood.
When I wear it, it's not like I'm putting on, you know, a piece of jewelry. It's I'm putting it on very mindfully, you know. So it's just every time I have this on, it just draws my attention to that awareness. But it was very important for us that whatever profits we made from this went directly back to our community in whichever way we could.
The pins are made by Indigenous women in Guatemala, and all proceeds go to support Indigenous community organization, The Circle Project. The Circle Project hosts culturally based addictions and family violence programs, as well as AA meetings, NA meetings, family nights, and childcare. The group says these programs are crucial for helping Indigenous women at risk and the families of those who suffered because of missing and murdered Indigenous women and girls.
Our work in family violence is very important because that is a risk factor. Saskatchewan, unfortunately, is the highest family violence area in the whole country. That puts people at risk. Children brought up in violent homes are more at risk. So that's one of the things that we're doing to be really proactive.
Priscilla Setti, a Cree activist for Indigenous rights and women's rights, says things will not get better for Indigenous women until people understand the past.
The history of this country is one of denigrating Indigenous women during that settlement period. And that really laid the foundation for the disparities that we see today. Women living in poverty, women being victimized. I mean, it didn't just happen overnight. It was a series of laws and policies that really broke down family and community structures.
Setti says the governments and other organizations need to come together to make communities more safe for Indigenous people. Meanwhile, the Circle Project says wearing red dress pins is a special way to spread that awareness.
It dies in the light. So all the things that are happening in the darkness, in the dark corners, when we can shine a bright light on it, it brings hope to the community, and that's what it's about. So it's about wearing the pin. It's about buying one. It's about, you know, having those conversations with people that inquire about the pin and educate yourself about what the pin means and, you know, the significance of it across the country.
With the help of donated funds like those from a warehouse books, the Circle Project plans to move into a new North Central location this fall, a bigger space that will help even more people in the community. Laura Sharpaletti, CBC News, Regina.